الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أفضل المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. وبعد, it's my pleasure to be with you in this blessed month, the month of Ramadan. It's the month of Rahmah, it's the month of forgiveness, it's the month of generosity, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives in ways that are beyond comprehension. It is the month of openings, the month where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-fattah, the opener, the one that opens any closed doors, any closed gates, opens unto his servants that which is beyond their comprehension. Sometimes, brothers and sisters, we are in a position in life that we feel things are just tight. We're in a dead end. All doors seems to be closed. Sometimes we need an opening. Some people need an opening in their relationships. Perhaps a relationship with someone that I love that has been tense for like years and months. And will it be that this Ramadan that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open? Is there something that I can do that will help an opening happen in this blessed days of the month of Ramadan? Some people, they have doors that are closed in terms of finances, in terms of provision. Will the month of Ramadan be the month where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens unto me with provisions? He's a Razzaq in ways that, again, I can't comprehend. And some want spiritual openings, want openings that are beyond the materialistic world. There are spiritual openings, openings that are better than anything that we seek from this world. An opening of rahmah, an opening of understanding, an opening of love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today I want to share with you a key, a door if you will, a door or a key that opens one of the best doors ever that we want and we seek. And it's based on a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the following: من فتح له باب الدعاء فتحت له أبواب الرحمة. Very powerful hadith. Whoever the door of dua, the door of supplication, has been opened unto him, indeed the doors, plural, the doors of rahmah, the loving compassion and mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been opened to him. What does that mean? Where am I with dua in this month? Dua is a door, and dua itself needs opening. Have you ever thought of that? They say, إِذَا فَتَحَ لَكَ بَابِ الدُّعَاءِ فَاعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ أَرَادَ أَنْ يُعْطِيكَ. No, that if you find that the doors of dua, that I'm making dua often and sincerely, if that door is open, rest assured that he wants to give you. You will be given. No question about it. And what will Allah give? Not necessarily what I'm asking for. He'll give something better. He'll give his rahmah, his loving compassion. قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. Say, with the favors of Allah and with His rahmah, with His loving compassion, with that let them rejoice, it's better than anything else they ask for. The companions, radiallahu anhu, knowing that, and this is the practical advice I want to share with you today. Before entering the month of Ramadan, they say, we would sit, knowing that the month of Ramadan is a month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed will respond and will open, we would prepare 2-3 du'as, 4 du'as, and we enter the month of Ramadan every single day. We ask for those things. In our sujood, whenever we're praying, we ask for them. When we break our fast, remember that, brothers and sisters, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Any person who's fasting, the moment he breaks his fast, if he makes du'a, Allah will respond. It will never be turned down. So, problem is sometimes we just make dua, whatever comes, good, alhamdulillah. But can you imagine if we're focused? Imagine if I enter this month and I have prepared my dua. I have an intention during this month, every single salah while in sujood. Every time I'm going to be breaking my fast. The last one third of the night, between adhan and iqama, all the moments I will be asking for those 3 or 4 things. The companion said, we would do that at the beginning of the month. The month ends and we got anything we asked for. So prepare your dua. What do I want? Maybe for Allah to guide someone in my family. Maybe for Allah to cure my heart of one of its ailments. Maybe for a provision. Maybe for health. Maybe Allah to protect my kids. Something that you really want. Three or four things. Maybe a dua for the ummah. We need this dua, right? And every single day have the intention, brothers and sisters. Open that door. Open the dua, the door of dua in this month. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens unto you the doors of His loving compassion and His rahmah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to envelop us all with His rahmah, with loving compassion in that month of rahmah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open unto all of us the door of dua, to enable us, to enable our tongues to be fluent with dua, to enable our hearts to be present in the dua, and to worship Him in the best and the most beautiful way that He loves. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik, la ilaha illa ant, wa jazakum Allah khair, until I see you again inshallah in another episode. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
صلِّ وسلِّم دائماً أبداً.